Lawmakers from the European Parliament visit former Philippine Senator Laila de Lima. Some members of the EU delegation arrived at the PNP custodial center in Camp Crame Thursday afternoon. No details yet of their meeting. Lawmakers from the regional bloc have long called for her release since her arrest in 2017. Meanwhile, Amnesty International renewed its plea for de Lima's release on the eve of her sixth year in detention. The rights watchdog calls her imprisonment a travesty based on bogus charges. It also urges the Marcos administration to ensure her immediate release and hold to account those responsible for what it calls de Lima's arbitrary detention. Before their meeting, the Justice Secretary, the EU lawmakers, met with Progressive Group Makabayan Bloc. Gabriela Partilist says the two sides discussed the International Criminal Court's probe on Duterte's drug war and the attacks on women and children. The Progressive Bloc also submitted a compilation of House resolutions seeking congressional inquiry on state-perpetrated human rights violations.
Visiting EU lawmakers meet with Philippine Justice Secretary Jesus Crispin Rimulya. Johnson Manaba joins us on the line with the details. Johnson.
Hi, Ron. Good afternoon. Members of the European Parliament made a courtesy call with Philippine Justice Secretary Jesus Crispin Boying Rimulya at the DOJ office here in Manila. The European Parliament arrived at the DOJ building this afternoon and had a closed-door meeting with Secretary Rimulya and other officials of the Justice Department. Secretary Rimulya welcomed the members of the European Parliament Subcommittee on Human Rights. In a statement, the Justice Department said, today's visit of the European Parliament Subcommittee on Human Rights took place in the context of the open and regular engagement on human rights issue between the Philippines and the European Union. The DOJ said they aim to further engage in a constructive dialogue and cooperation on human rights. DOJ said, the delegation of the European Union in the country visits different countries every year using their own budget as part of the European Parliament Subcommittee's core work. Present during the meeting include officials of the Department of Interior and Local Government and other agencies of the Philippine government. According to DOJ, during the dialogue, representatives of various government agencies affirmed the importance of continued dialogue and cooperation with the European Union. The delegation arrived in the country yesterday and will stay until tomorrow, February 24. The European Parliament is one of the European Union's legislative bodies and seven institutions. Ron.
That story from Johnson Manaba. Thanks, Johnson.
The Philippines' acting prisons chief has requested a special civil service exam for corrections employees at risk of losing their jobs. 345 Bureau of Corrections employees are facing possible dismissal due to a lack of professional qualifications. Under the law, BUCOR employees must be college graduates with civil service eligibility. Around 50 of them may be given special exams to gain the necessary professional requirements. The rest will no longer take the test since they are nearing retirement.
Lahat po, ginawa na po namin. Sabi naman po ni Chairman, dumulog sila sa amin, action na namin as soon as possible. Pwedeng personal appeal na lang po kasi hindi nyo nga po alam kung ano-anong mga kaso niyan individually.
Power rates in the Philippines expected to go down as the government puts on hold once more the collection of a charge to ensure renewable energy. Manila's energy regulator suspended the collection of the feed-in tariff allowance for another 6 months. The agency cited the continued rise in inflation and cost of living for the suspension. It said the fund's current balance can cover payment requirements until August this year.